Previously on Last of the Nice Guys, these three fine gentlemen known as Jason, Joe, and Manny were discussing an article from Yahoo Life, how cheaters and liars react to being called out. It was a fun, rip-roaring good time. But now, the fun continues.
So, what are we talking about today?
Today on GEEK BROS Podcast 140, we've got Masters of the Universe Revelation Part 2 official trailer. Jim Carrey rumored to be casted as MODOK for a future MCU movie. The Book of Boba Fett official trailer or teaser trailer review. Lightyear official teaser trailer review. Facebook is rebranding itself as Meta. The Witcher Season 2 official trailer review. And Star Wars Visions Episode 4 review. And I'm absolutely sure I did this outline better in Last of the Nice Guys. All this and more on this week's episode. Stay tuned.
Never looked so good. Two incredibly sexy men will rise for your auditory pleasure. Here's your hosts, Keeping Up with the Geek Bros.
Yes, yes, Keeping the Geek Bros podcast. I'm Vi, with me are our man, and the return, ladies and gentlemen, of Joe Taro. Yeah. We somehow got Joe Taro. We convinced him to jump on the Geek Bros podcast after Last of the Nice Guys, which is a fantastic podcast.
Yeah, I'm not even up right now.
No, he's not.
No idea what's going on.
He's not. So we just threw him on here because, you know, nobody else is coming on. And I'm pretty sure man and I...
The
that's
shade.
That's not shade. It's just reality. No one else is coming on. No one else is answering the text messages. What was that? I told you need to take your daughter to the pediatrician. I told you that. But anyway,
and apparently his head because his glasses are on.
His glasses are on. but yeah. So I, you know, we got Joe Tartar to grace us with his presence, and it is fantastic. Plus, Dick. You know, I cannot confirm or deny that Man and I are getting tired of doing this alone. So, thanks, Dave. Joe Tar, for gracing your presence for this good episode. And we are the hosts of the Keeping the Geek Bros podcast, a family podcast, allegedly. Let's go on. Hit us up with the next topic or the next thing. You're playing Darflex for today's play.
So, gentlemen, what's on your mind? No, wait.
Definitely the wrong one. That's absolutely
okay. No, I got it. My bad. What's going on with the Geek Bros?
Well, nothing. No, that's a lie. I did mention that the Venom review was gonna come out last week. I apologize it didn't come out last week because I just want to do one more pass. When I rewatched the Black Widow review, it was great. But there's so many things that I wanted to do after the fact. And I said, if I had watched it one more time and I let my creative juices flow, I would have added more jokes and more things. So I'm going to go one more pass on it. And I will guarantee you that it's coming out this week. Other than the fact that Joe Taro is here, nothing else going on. But we're still trying to plan this, the Dune and the Free. And now Free Guy, we're actually going to look forward to the Free Guy review. Now that Man is caught up on that, he's going to watch Free
what
Guy.
What a great movie.
We might actually rewatch it. That's something that we can actually rewatch. Is that something we can watch on TV? No, it's not. Is it?
Yes.
That's something I might consider us rewatching it together here with some drinks and then do a review. So we're not doing that for Dune. Dune has to be in a theater, IMAX if at all possible. But look forward to that and more. So, gents, what's on your mind? We're going to start with Joe Taro, who hasn't been here in probably like 40 episodes. Joe Taro, where have you been? What's on your mind?
Well, roughly like what, a year or two?
Yeah.
Or three, right?
No, it's been like maybe a year or so.
When was the year we went to Chicago for Star Wars?
2019? That was 2 years ago. Yeah, it's 2 years ago.
Yep, there you go. Bing, bang, boom. 2 years ago has been since I've been on this podcast. And I tell you, I don't miss it. But I will tell you one thing, though. I will say one thing, though. I am very excited for this lineup. And you know, let me just point out Vibe that I have been listening here and there. I have been listening here and there to the Geek Bros from time to time. You know, it still amazes me how much information you guys can pass around each other. But 9 times out of 10, I do not agree with anything that you guys say whatsoever. But hey, I'm here.
Thank you so much, Joe Tarr. It's always a pleasure. Yeah, Madman, what's on your mind? No dead air. Oh,
there goes his mic.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
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 Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. New York. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Madman, yeah. We can't hear you. God damn it.
I'm sorry, my kids keep coming out here and I'm like, I'm sorry.
The interpretation of the New York symbol.
That was really good. All I saw was
New York.
Sorry, yeah, I'm watching the game right now at the same time. So I don't really have anything new. Work has become more stressful because the idea of competition, you know, capitalism, the idea of it actually, they took it upon themselves to delve into that idea, and they've done a lot of stuff that doesn't make any damn sense. So yeah, I stopped being happy there a while ago. It just got worse. One of my coworkers has left, and I'm mad at him because he's leaving before I did. So whatever, that's fine. We won't talk about it. It's super emotional.
That's exactly how I felt. That, every time a coworker left or got another job or got a whatever, I was mad. I really was. It was hard for me to feel happy for them when I knew they were leaving me in a cesspool. Carry on.
No, not me at all.
Yeah, we don't talk about your privileges. But other than that, yeah, that's all I got. I got nothing else. Everything else is the same. Yeah, that's it.
For me, it's official. I am officially dating a ghost, and it is it is absolutely a humbling experience to be dating somebody who it's hard to communicate with. And disappears and then reappears and disappears. So yeah, it's a hell of a thing to date an apparition, but I'll keep you guys posted with that. Other than that, just happy to be here. Things are things. All right, so without further ado, episode 140 starts now. But first, subscribe to our podcast. No matter who actually is hosting at any given day, it's the right thing to do. We're moving on to the fresh scent. All right, Geek Bros approved movies of the week. The Eternals, Friday, November 5th. Following the events of Avengers Endgame, an unexpected tragedy forces the Eternals, an ancient aliens who have been living on Earth in secret for thousands of years, out of the shadows to reunite against mankind's most ancient enemy, the Deviants. Who's actually going to watch this? Oh, okay.
Me.
Well,
me.
Are you okay? Are you actually interested in it?
I mean, I am because of the continuation of the
No.
Of the multiverse.
That's why I'm watching it. That's why Madman's watching it. That's why me and Madman are going to review it as part of a Geek Bros. But are you, as an individual movie, are you interested in it?
Yeah. I'm not really watching it to review it on
no,
you guys.
I know that.
Fuck, but are you guys. I'm watching it for my...
No, but are you watching it because you're interested in that movie by itself? Or you're watching it only because you know you want to follow the story and the narrative that flows through these movies? Why are you really watching
the story, the narrative? I'm not
okay. So you don't really want to watch it. You're just watching your Marvel shit like the rest of us,
right?
That's what it is. I have no, like, just like Shang-Chi, which was surprisingly delightful, by the way.
I love that. I love Shang-Chi.
Unlike Black Widow, which was absolutely dreadful.
Surprisingly,
okay, absolutely dreadful. I think that the Eternals is going to be like a Black Widow. I think it's going to be insignificant. I have no real personal interest in seeing this movie. I'm going to watch it because it's part of my job. I'm a geek bro, and that's what we do. But I have no interest. The trailers don't give me any anything. I don't care about the story. I don't care about the all-star cast. Man, how you feel?
Definitely, I'm interested to see, because I know very little about the Eternals. So I want to see how they go and portray this storyline into the continuation of the MCU that we are aware of and what we're about to begin.
Yeah, but that's how I felt about Guardians of the Galaxy. I knew nothing about them, but the trailers at least looked interesting, and I was curious how they're going to weave the cosmic into the story. I don't feel that way about the Eternals. I actually don't want to see the Eternals. I want to skip the movie. I won't, but I'd like to.
I know a little bit about the backstory of them only because of like for, you know, for example, I used to go about reading, you know, manga all the time. So in the midst of reading that, I would like just dive into like Marvel and DC comic books, whatever. And mm-hmm. Yeah, there's like little bits and pieces I know about them, but not fully, because they really never been talked to in the mainstream like this. This is the first time they've actually been introduced. So, you know, not many people are actually going to, well, now they will, because they'll probably Google it and look it up and all that other shit, but no one really knows that much about them. So,
all right. So we're going to move on now to Man-Man's side piece, Masters of the Universe Revelation trailer review. I'm not watching this because I don't care. So you can definitely, I'm not streaming this at all either. I only like the Masters of the Universe because of a whole Kevin Smith, you suck because you killed He-Man kind of bullshit that I loved. I loved it. But other than that, I didn't watch the series. I don't care. So you can bring it up. We're not streaming it on this podcast. Look it up if you want to look it up. Go for it.
Okay. Well, if you watch the teaser trailer, you see that miraculously somehow, what the hell's her name? The She-Man?
She-Ra. She-Man. It's funny. I don't watch the show. I know nothing about the lore. The lore. But what about the lore?
Actually, it's not She-Ra. It's Tila.
Tila Tequila. Yeah.
Yeah, she actually, interestingly enough, works on her magic and becomes, as the trailer goes, you see that she actually gains, you know, more, she gets more powerful and whatever, to the point where we watched He-Man die last season, and he is revived this season. So, yeah, magic. And then you see a fight with, what the hell is his name? Between He-Man and
Skeletor.
Skeletor, yeah.
Did you watch this trailer? Or?
I did. I did watch this trailer. I watched the trailer earlier. I actually watched this trailer when I woke up this morning. Okay. The names are like, you know, they're losing me. Yeah, but there you see a big fight between, because again, when the season ended last season ended. You see Skeletor with the power sword and he becomes super powerful. Like he becomes a He-Man version of himself. And you see He-Man as his alter ego. I forget his name too, whatever. You know, frail self. And he goes, the funny thing about becoming He-Man and the power is that I'm the spark. And then he just goes as the power, you know, whatever, blah, 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 his little catchphrase. And then he becomes like a primitive version of He-Man and just goes ape shit all over Skeletor. Like, it's just, it's pretty interesting to watch if you're interested in watching the show, the series. Of course, I'm going to watch it because, you know, that's just who I am. I watch everything. But yeah, that's basically where it's at. It's coming soon. I forget when it is. November 23rd is when it premieres on Netflix.
I just love the Skeletor memes going around on the internet. I think those are absolutely hilarious.
Yeah, they're hilarious. He comes out and says something and he says, hey, guess you didn't know this. Oh, I'll be back later. And then buzz out.
Absolutely gold. I love it. Jay, you know, I mean, Vibe, you know what I'm talking about?
Nope. Tell me more. Idea.
He says, tell me
more. No, it's a meme. It's a Skeletor meme.
Right.
I'll send it through the chat. What Man-Man just said. It basically,
I got it. I'm working on it now.
Send it to him now because Vibe is a little slow up there. And down there. Both. He knows. Right. I'm not interested in the Master of the Universe either, by the way. I know Vibe was gonna ask me, but no. I'm not entirely interested. Never was. I think the last time I actually watched He-Man was when I was like, what? 15, 16. And we're talking about the old school He-Man, not like the new one. The very, very old school one. Not this new Netflix crap that new. These young kids are watching.
It's so new. What about the
lore? You got to stay woke, bro.
I think I really messed this thing up.
Yeah, it's about that woke stuff. Yeah, about that crap.
I don't remember.
Back then I liked it.
I don't remember the cartoon from back then at all. Oh my God. I just saw a very interesting picture of He-Man and Skeletor that I will post for you guys. That's pretty much all I got on Masters of the Universe Part 2. Revelations Part 2, sorry.
What I'm trying to do is I
darkened my screen and I don't know how I did that. And I want to show you guys the trailer, but I can't show you guys the trailer if I can't fix my screen. That's so weird. That is incredibly weird. I think we'll be right back. And we're back. I fixed my screen. So now we're going to move on to the Book of Boba Fett trailer. We're actually going to watch that now because I haven't watched it. And I will share my screen like I do.
Oh, snap.
Actual what? Oh, snap what? No, oh, snapping. There we go. Shared, brought up, and go. What is that supposed to be?
I am not a bounty hunter.
There you are. I thought he fixed that.
I've heard otherwise.
Okay. Oh, that's cool.
The logo?
Yeah, it looks like Boba Fett's armor.
I know that you sit on the throne of your former employer.
Is that the Mandalorian?
Yeah.
Jabba ruled with fear.
I thought he cleaned up his armor.
I intend to rule with respect.
You were all once captains under Jabba the Hutt.
I'm here to make a proposal that's mutually beneficial.
That's some good shit.
Why speak of conflict? And cooperation can make us all rich.
What prevents us all from killing you and taking what we want?
Yes!
If you had spoken such insolence to Jabba, he'd have fed you to his menagerie.
Please. Speak freely.
Okay. Okay.
See? Feeling that, huh? I like that a lot.
Here's my problem, though. Continuity-wise, did he not clean up his armor before he sat in that chair? Why is it looking scruffy again, and why is the dent back there again?
Listen, man, it's Disney. They do what the fuck they want.
I know.
There was one shot where his armor looked really crisp.
Did it? Because
yeah,
unless you tell
really
me
he got clean.
There's no chance in hell he got shot in the exact same spot again. Like, you give me a break. But
maybe somebody's like, you know, strike one, strike two, you know, third time I'll get you.
But I won't lie to you. That teaser was boss. I like that a lot. But we did hear the Mandalorian's voice in there, right?
Yeah, he narrated in the beginning.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yep.
It might have been a flashback. No.
Yeah, Mr.
Pascal, yes.
Yes, Mr. Pascal. I liked it. I like what I saw. It's going to be on Tatooine. It'd be nice. Oh, no, I was going to say it'd be nice if this crossed over with Obi-Wan, but Obi-Wan is a different time. But the story, I hope the story is not just about him taking over Jabba and dealing with the fallout of that. I really hope it's not just that. I hope there's something more to it. I don't want him to be a good guy. Don't get me wrong. I don't want him. I barely even want him to be an anti-hero. I want him to be ruthless and heavy, but I want him to have more than just, I've taken over Jabba's palace and this is what happens afterwards. I hope there's more to it than that. A little grandeur. A little bit. What do you guys think?
I mean, I actually liked it.
I enjoyed it. I'm definitely going to watch it. It's listed here that he navigates the underworld of the galaxy with the mercenary Fennec Shand as they return to the sands of Tatooine to stake their claim on the territory formerly ruled by the deceased crime lord Jabba the Hutt. So where they're going to go from there, I have no idea. That's just, I mean, I'm going to watch
it, obviously. I hope they explain why he wants Jabba's, like, palace, like why, you know, he's a bounty hunter. I don't see him being a criminal underworld boss. I don't, you know, I never took him for that. I took him for a loner.
Yeah, I never really took him. Yeah, I took him for like a loner mercenary.
Get my money, whatever. Kind of what the Mandalorian actually is, you know, or was before he met Baby Yoda. So I'm thrilled. I'm excited. I'm gonna watch this. I'm gonna watch the hell out of this.
It's how are they gonna continue? I'm wondering with season two. Which I'm sure there'll be a, of this. I'm sure there'll be a season two, but I'm wondering.
I don't think so.
If that's the premise of the whole story for season one, I'm wondering how they're going to play it off at season two. Like, what are they going to do next?
I think it's been confirmed it's only a one season thing. It's a one and done.
Oh, really?
I'm pretty sure it was a one and done, and it was put out there to delay the Mandalorian season three as they rework some shit. So I don't know. But if there's more, it's great. As long as the story, I didn't really like Fennec Shand at all, so hopefully she grows on me. I liked her a little bit more in the what was it, Bad Batch, than I did in The Mandalorian. Well, that's not true. I thought she was badass in The Mandalorian in that episode, so I changed my mind.
She was very badass.
Yeah, she was bad off in it. So, man, what do you think about this trailer before we move on to the next trailer?
I like it. I'm watching. So, yeah, we'll go from there.
I enjoyed it. Pretty good. All right, we're going to move on to The Cure for Your Common Day, Lightyear official teaser trailer review. And we're going to share this right now because that's how we do. Share.
And this is what I do.
This is what I do.
Anytime now. Anytime.
It's got to go through the, you know, the motions.
Go. All right.
He's got the shape head of every NYPD officer.
This will be a hell of a ride at Disney. Okay. You know, if you believe in space and whatnot.
Yeah, you know. Because you really can't leave the Earth.
Bam. Okay. That's really close to the sun. That'll burn you the fuck up. Ooh. Yes.
Okay, he's wearing a Star Command shirt.
He is. This seems kind of a little intense. Yes. Oh, there's the classic outfit.
Wow.
To infinity.
And.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. Now I'm digging that. It's got a Cars 3 vibe to it. It's clearly Buzz Lightyear origin story, if Buzz Lightyear was not a toy.
But what aren't they? Are they basing the toy off of this guy?
Yeah.
Probably.
That's what I'm thinking.
But then the question is this like the movie within the Toy Story universe, or is this the actual guy? But it can't be the actual guy because the technology shown in this is far outstrips that what you saw in Toy Story. There's no way this kind of thing existed while they during Toy Story. So maybe this is the Buzz Lightyear movie within the Toy Story universe. You know, the greedy reboot.
Yeah, how would they spin this? That's confusing.
That's how they're spinning it. You're gonna see Andy with maybe his kid taking him to see the Buzz Lightyear, the Lightyear reboot movie, and it cuts directly to this. Guaranteed. Guaranteed. It's going to start in the Toy Story universe with Andy's child saying, when Papa was little, I love this guy. Let's go see.
When Papa was little.
let's go see this together. Okay. I love the trailer. And apparently, Chris Evans plays Buzz Lightyear. How do you guys feel about that?
Definitely a lot better pick than for Mario.
too soon. So, Lightyear official trailer. Watch the Disney Pixar Lightyear movie trailer. The sci-fi action adventure presents the dignified origin story of Disney's Buzz Lightyear, the hero who inspired the toy. Oh, introducing the legendary space ranger who would win generations of fans. Chris Evans lends his voice to Buzz Lightyear. Annie, award-winning director and veteran Pixar animator Angus McLean, who directed 2006 Finding Dory, helms Lightyear. So, okay, then we're wrong. This is the real story of the guy who inspired the toy. But the problem with that is the technology that you see doesn't match the Toy Story world. Unless you're telling me this is some Wetworks thing where it's so deep into the like Black Ops that you don't know. And now I'm getting into conspiracy theories with this. So moving on. But yeah. But before we move on, guys, checking it out. I want to check this out. I do.
I would check it out.
Yeah, why not? So there you go. 2022, if Geek Bros is still around. There's a review there with me and Manny, clearly. So check that out in the future. All right, we're going to move on to Facebook is rebranding itself as Meta. Now, this article comes from yahoo.com/news/finance. Facebook is rebranding itself as Meta. Facebook, the social network, will no longer define the future of Facebook, the company that will be known as Meta. Facebook Inc. is changing the name in order to distinguish itself, distinguish its beleaguered social network, which has increasingly poor reputation around the globe, from the company that it's pinned to. So, and they promise a metaverse. So basically, Facebook, the website, is not changing. The company Facebook now is going to change. So, i.e., it's like if my company was named Geek Bros, but Geek Bros still stay the same, but I'm rebranding my company to VibeRev Studios. So that's all they're really saying is that the Facebook corporation is now going to be called Meta. Facebook is just going to be one product. The Facebook website will be one product of Meta. It says our brand is so tightly linked to one product that it can't possibly represent everything that we are doing today, let alone in the future, Zuckerberg said. From now on, we're going to be Metaverse first, not Facebook first. So Facebook is no longer going to be the flagship of his company. Zuckerberg announced the new name during a virtual Meta virtual, if you will, keynote for the company's Connect event. Under its new arrangement, Facebook and its family of apps will be a division of a larger Meta company, which will still be led by Zuckerberg. So it's just a restructuring. It's kind of like how Google restructured itself into Alphabet. Alphabet is the company that owns Google, but Alphabet used to be known as Google. But because Google is more than just a search engine, they have it's an umbrella now. So Meta is just an umbrella for Facebook and Instagram and WhatsApp and all the other stuff that's here now and coming in the future. So what do you guys think about Meta?
I think we spoke about it earlier in our other podcast, like briefly. No, not like not live, but we spoke about it off air. But
we did, we did.
Yeah, because I was curious. I was like, is it going to be like a VR thing? And if
that's one thing. That's one thing that they're going to do, like a Miiverse or whatever it is. That's
something. Well, man, you mentioned it would be like that PlayStation thing that they introduced.
Yeah, the PlayStation thing that they originally had, I think, for the PS3, where you were in the galley,
like the lobby or something like that.
Lobby room, and you were just rolling around like with your avatar and walking, talking to other people.
Facebook previously said it plans to separate Facebook Reality Labs, its AR or augmented reality and VR groups, from the rest of the company when reporting their final performance.
So I think it's cool though. I think it's pretty cool.
It is, and it's funny because there's a video that says that this is really not cool. That this is part of the sequestering and the the human population where they're already kind of locked in, like, oh, don't go outside, oh, stay inside, oh, work from home. Yeah. And now it's
going to be all bad.
Yeah. Now it's, oh, why go outside when you can meet virtually online with VR and your Miiverse? And why don't you do that? It's,
yeah. You don't even have to get dressed anymore. You can change from your lineup of outfits that you've purchased.
I.e. a dystopian future, kind of like what was seen in Ready Player One. Ready Player One.
I was just about to say that.
Ready Player One, what people don't know is that that's a dystopian future story. That's a story where people have given up on the real world and they're focused on the Oasis. That is, there's hope about it. Oh, at the end, but that was pure dystopia. So that's one theory, is that this is bringing us to that dystopian future where nobody even goes out anymore, you know, and we all stay inside. And the more electronics and the more technology we use to communicate into our lives, is the more our freedoms get restricted, the more monitoring,
and the more that, everything. And the more of the humans in the movie Wall-E, that becomes a thing too, where we're eating out of straws, we're flying around on chairs, we're fat, you know, because we're not moving. Yeah, that's going to be a thing too.
Right, and then the elites, they're going to be the ones that are fit and whatever, because you know they've allowed us to gave us all technology to become complacent. And soft and doughy. This is not a good thing.
I also think that my take on this is they're also like the brand, I guess you can, they're trying to push their blame on everything that's currently happening with them.
Yep.
On like, oh, we're Meta, bro. Like, that's Facebook. Mm-hmm. We don't do that at Meta. Mm-hmm. Like Instagram, all that crap that they're doing over there with the little girls and hurting people's feelings. Mm-hmm. And Facebook, oh, the controversy with Facebook's. That's another department. We're Meta. We're all about making
Meta,
you fat.
Guys.
Yeah, we're Meta. We're all about making you fat and giving you technology and doing other stuff to you. But that other stuff, that's not us.
No, but it's funny about that. It's funny about that. Yeah. Facebook is just a division of us. That's not us.
Yeah.
No, you're absolutely right. Because the sad part is that we human beings, we have memories like goldfish. In a couple of years, you're going to forget that Meta has anything to do with Facebook.
Yep.
You know, you're going to forget. Facebook's still going to be around, but you're going to forget. And that's the sad part. We have such limited memory for things. It's the craziest thing. I think this is just as concerning to me as when Disney bought Fox and Star Wars and all these other things they bought, because I was like, it's not good. You're concentrating entertainment under one roof, and you could only get so many voices in the same location. You know, where's the competition? Competition arises creativity. Creativity is innovation. But when you start doing these things like this, you slow down the progress of humanity. You stifle it. So I'm sorry if this is. I mean, it's just Facebook rebranding and stuff is Meta, and we're getting a little deeper than this. But you have to get deeper. You have to see beyond these simple things. There's more going on than just a name change and a black turtleneck.
Yep.
And a black turtleneck.
You know, that's all pretty I have to say. We're going to move on to The Witcher Season 2 official trailer review. I didn't see this, so I have to watch this. So
hold on, I'm gonna plug in my last topic that we didn't go over for like two seconds, because there's really nothing to talk about.
I didn't see it. Where was it?
You read it on the top when on the opener, but this gentleman right here. It's real quick. There's nothing confirmed, strictly rumor, but this guy is going to be playing this guy in the
Madman. I want to make it very clear that this is first and foremost a podcast. So they don't know what this guy, they don't even know what you're pointing to if you're not watching this on YouTube.
This guy here, Mr. Jim Carrey, American treasure, a lovely American, Mr. Funny Guy. I've got a lot of those. I'm not going to keep going.
That's not Paul Rudd.
No, that's America's fantasy. No,
because he's aging. The difference.
Yeah, yeah. So Paul Rudd doesn't age. This guy ages, but he's still a legend. So Jim Carrey here.
You're right. He's a legend.
Jim Carrey here has been rumored, and this comes from several websites, comic books, something, and blah blah. You know, there's a blah blah blah. That's it. Will be casted in the future MCU, unnamed MCU movie, They are claiming something as soon as Black Panther 2 the Ant-Man and the Wasp.
I can see that.
Captain America 4. Definitely not that. They're throwing that out there. But this individual here is MODOK. For those of you who don't know very much about MODOK, there is a series on Hulu that absolutely horrifically describes who he is.
I stopped watching halfway through. I couldn't do it.
It's true. He's right.
But MODOK.
But Patton Oswalt as MODOK is a great choice. Yeah, they should have just brought it over as live action. Why not?
Yeah, they should have.
He's short and stubby like MODOK. Why not? I'm just saying. But whatever.
You're saying Patton Oswalt got a big fucking head?
Well, yeah, but he's short and stubby. I just put a little bit of makeup, a little CG on him. And you would have had MODOK and you'd have had the same voice, but you know, who cares?
But MODOK is a villain originally known as Dr. George Tarleton, who God has bless you. Thank you. COVID has designed a who worked for a company called AIM, which is Advanced Idea Mechanics, which has been introduced or named in Iron Man.
Three. Yes.
Whatever movie that is, because
I am the Mandarin.
Exactly. You cut off and here's my arm. Where it was found by his father, Alvin. He was born in Maine, blah, 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 where he creates a cosmic tube to further advance his neurological and, you know, his mind, basically, which is the little chair that he sits in. He becomes overwhelmed with power and his mind and everything, but he just kind of becomes like the smartest guy everywhere and says, I want to rule the world. That's basically what MODOK does. He fails several times, but that is his intentions. He wants to be the intellect that runs the world and takes over everything. So I don't know how I feel about Jim Carrey playing MODOK.
I see him playing him very similar to Dr. Robotnik. In Sonic.
Honestly, I didn't really like him as Dr. Robotnik.
I hated him as Dr. Robotnik. I couldn't stand him as Dr. Robotnik.
Yeah, but I wasn't a big fan of him.
But that's how I see him playing MODOK is Dr. Robotnik. That's probably why he got MODOK, because of Dr. Robotnik in Sonic. That's probably what we want. So
it didn't look canon to that guy.
What'd you say, Nick? What was it? Nick Cannon said what?
No. I said, Dr. Robotnik didn't look canon to me. I mean, for someone who played Sonic games growing up all the fucking time.
That was the origin story of Dr. Robotnik. And in the end, I don't know if he was fat at the end, but he started looking closer to it in the end. So, you know, who knows? So if that's it, I'd love to move on to The Witcher.
Yeah, go ahead. That's it. Just a quick jump in there.
The Witcher season 2 trailer review. Check this out, y'all. Sexy girlfriend.
Where is she?
Something has changed, girl.
Yes, it has. It's no longer a time trip.
Strange these days.
Oh shit!
The north and south at war. Monsters roaming when they should be hibernating. Maybe it's the end of days.
Are you willing to sacrifice your life?
Darkness rises.
I've lived through 3 supposed end of days. It's all horseshit.
All right. Damn.
This continent was meant for no one. Woo. None of us will have any
peace. Yes!
Yennefer!
Until there are no monsters left in the world.
Everybody know.
That's my home. My fight.
Finally!
Your precious leader's after something. Got a pawn to get to it.
Rebuild our forces. Strengthen our numbers. We are an empire. The war's just begun.
Oh, shit. Look at all this budget, yo!
There is an
Yeah, this looks so much better than the
Casino.
Our best chance.
face it. Are you ready for this?
Yes, yes, yes.
Yes. I've been ready.
If what you say about that girl's power is true, you can't help her.
Budget.
Ooh, a lesson.
Oh. Man, myth, legend.
Oh.
First, gentlemen, it's been an honor. What? I made new friends. Get over it. Jealous?
Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Absolutely.
So this takes me back to playing the game. Now they're putting canon shit in it, which makes it,
yeah,
it's great.
Now, I never played the game. I don't give a shit about the game.
You suck at life.
That trailer was bitchin'. Okay. Do you see the budget? All I saw was budget. Holy shit, budget.
Oh, yeah. It looks so much more beautiful. Not that the first season wasn't bad.
Exactly. The first season was great.
They were just like, we did so well. Let's throw more money on top of it and make it. And oh, visually, this was amazing.
Pure budget.
The spells.
That budget, he, like, yo.
Oh, man.
Budget.
I
can't wait. In a perfect world, we're going to review every single episode of The Witcher season 2. Whether it be, but not on the podcast. This deserves its own, like,
web series?
No, its own little mini series, like the countdown. You know what? I need to get, I don't know, man. Man is so busy. I would love to do a countdown to season 2 where we review all of season 1. Actually, this gives me a great idea to actually release the original Witcher review in honor of season 2. How about that? That'd be great.
Wait. You have until December 17th, sir.
I'll get it in December. I think because I've been on the fence about it. Of course, it has two former Geek Bros in it, which is fine. But I mean, and then I'd love to do like a follow up with you, man. Just me and you, we rewatch the series. I don't know. You don't have to give me like a full day. We just binge it at my place with hookah and drinks. And then we just record.
I'm coming over.
Okay. You should fly down for this. That'd be great. Like, I mean, it'd be amazing. But let us know what you think. This is amazing. This trailer is amazing. Yeah. I know I'm going to love this season. I can't wait. This is so amazing. I don't even want to do the Star Wars Visions episode 4 review. Like, that's how I want to end this episode. But
dude, you should really think about, like, grabbing the games. Yeah. You really should think about it. Also, grabbing a PS5.
Star Wars Visions episode 4 The Village Bride. I'm gonna wrap it up. I mean a Jedi on the run is summoned by an old ally to take in a unique customs of a remote village under threat by a warlord. Here's the funny thing about this. Man summed it up in the beginning of this episode, well, not the beginning, but before we recorded, when he said, what was this episode again? That's the reality of it. There's nothing wrong with this episode. Animation is pretty solid. The dubbing is still god awful, okay. But I didn't care, and I honestly don't remember what this episode is about. I went on YouTube to see some clips. I was like, oh yeah, I did see this one. The battle, I believe, was pretty cool. I liked the sniper guy. It was cool to see battle droids. It really was. But the story was about sacrificing the princess to the droids to avoid something. And some Jedi invited another Jedi to come see, to probably bring her out of some kind of funk.
You're doing a horrible, horrible rendition.
Horrible.
Honestly, I saw this episode, but I don't remember much about it. And I know it didn't resonate with me at all. What about you, man?
So the episode was about a band of bandits that basically kind of forcefully took over the planet. And you have
bandits, they had battle droids.
Mercenaries, bandits, whatever you want to call them.
Okay.
They forcefully, you know, wanted to take over the planet, and they just decided, I guess, to, hey, you know, this native tribe or band of people that are living here, who are very close and I guess magical with the planet. Like they were part of the planet, like an avatar and a Jedi kind of force thing with the planet.
Yeah, you're doing much better at describing this than me.
Listen, that description is on par. Okay. It's like an avatar, like the Mother Earth is talking to me type nonsense. So this is, I guess it had something to do with like their resources of the planet, which is mm-hmm. why they chose to not kill them all and was like, all right, give us a bride and we'll remain cool. You know, we won't destroy everybody. And I guess there was two Jedis that you had mentioned that were invited, that this, whoever, I forgot her name in the episode. She's the one that actually fought back and pretty much saved everybody from it happening. Cause I don't remember if there was a plot. But yeah, but
I think it has something to do with bringing something out in her. Something happened to her where she wasn't caring about people, or she was wearing a mask or something. I don't know.
Yeah, and she was probably wearing a mask.
Right, and the Jedi invited her out there because he knew something was going to go down, and he wanted to bring back probably the hero inside of her. And eventually, it came back. I don't know. I wasn't digging it. Unfortunately for Jotaro, he hasn't watched any Star Wars Visions, and
I have
all I can say is don't listen to our review of this as a biting indictment of it. You really should watch it because episode one is the shit.
And that's it.
Yeah. Well, yeah. Okay. Anyway, episode one is the shit. So it's not Love, Death, Robots season one, that's for sure. But it's
season two.
It's not even season two. Season two is better than this so far. Anyway, stop. We'll get to it. So that's about it. So I guess we're going to wrap it up. Shameless promotion, gents, before we move on. Man.
I am Man on Facebook and YouTube, and Man 17093 on Twitter, IG, Snapchat, TikTok, and something else. I don't remember. But yeah,
that's I remember when this man only had like one social media. Like this is good for him. Geek Bros has been good.
Yeah,
for him.
We just had a conversation like a week ago where I was looking at my old posts. And they were like years apart.
Yep.
And I haven't been so involved. I haven't been so involved in my social media until the last year. So yeah.
And like I said, you're welcome. Jotaro, where can these fine people find you? Since we probably won't get you back on this podcast for another year or so.
Oh man. Joetarro. Three R's on Instagram. This is only Instagram. Only Instagram. However, two years ago, I had mentioned that I had a Facebook. Now I'm being a little bit more open about that. So you can find me on my Facebook as well. Joe Shanley, Shanley. And on Instagram, once again, Joetarro. I'm actually going to go play The Witcher. Still is worth time.
And I'm Vibe, the Vibe Rev Studios, VibeRevStudios. That's Instagram, Twitter.com, Facebook, YouTube. Just find me there. You'll see everything you want. You'll see this more. You'll see the Geek Bros, Last and Nice Guys, Friends with Issues, the Geek Bros original recipe web series, Holidays. There's plenty of stuff out there. I produce a lot of things. I work really hard. You have no idea. I have a day job. That being said, Geek Bros, you can find us. Without Jotaro, by the way, GEKBR0S, that's Twitter and Instagram, GEKBR0S at yahoo.com. Email us facebook.com/GEKBR0S. Yes, that's the hot spot there. It's where all the fun is. Check us out every week at WeBeGeeksPC.com, the first place to check us out. Hey. This podcast, please subscribe. And of course, you want to see these buttery faces, is youtube.com/VibeRevStudios. That's it for Keepin' Up the Geek Bros podcast. And remember, geeking out still sounds this good. Watch Last of the Nice Guys.
Your mom's.
Keepin' Up with the Geek Bros.